Welcome back to the Bislett Stadium. And time for yet another of the very, very good middle long distance events. 3,000 meters for men, one of those distances which will get the mixture of the 5K runners, the odd 1,500 meter runner. Ismail Karoui, as we can see there. World champion 2 years ago. He's got a very, very strong field here. We've seen some fantastic running already so far this year at 3K, 5K and 10K in particular. Probably the 3K hasn't quite been brought to the standards of the 5 and 10 so far this year. But certainly have some athletes in this field capable of doing that. Salah Hissou, who has been running very, very well, won this event in Nice last week, 7:35. He's looked very, very good form so far this year. Probably not one of the biggest names around, but he's starting to make a name for himself. Ran about 13.2 early on in the season for 5K. In fact, in Rome in that world record race, which almost went unnoticed. Dieter Baumann alongside him there, Olympic champion. He's looking to try and get himself back into some sort of form. Hasn't looked too impressive so far this year. An interesting race in prospect, Tim.
Yes, it is. As you said, the 3,000 hasn't really come alight yet this year, bar that race in Nice last week. 7:35 from Hissou, top-notch time. Although, when you think that it's 10 seconds slower than Morselli's world record from last year, it does make you realise what sort of level the Algerian is operating at now. Marcus O'Sullivan there, former world indoor record holder, out in front at the moment. Frank O'Mara, rather, excuse me. I knew it began with O. He's out in front and pulling them around at the moment at around 60 second pace. Now, Baumann has moved straight in second place. Di Napoli there in third place. Baumann ran 13:20 earlier in the season at Saint-Denis for 5,000 and apparently was very disappointed with the run. We haven't seen a great deal of him since, so it'll be fascinating to see just what sort of shape Baumann has pulled himself round into for these World Championships. No time to make any adjustments now, really, with just 2 weeks to go. But certainly the German letting his intentions be known here, and he looks very confident there in second place. 400 metres in around 60 seconds.
Well, this is interesting, Tim. We haven't seen really Baumann show that he's in any particular form to go out and chase fast times. He's got very, very good field here up against him. Already mentioned Karoui. Paul Bitok also in there from Kenya. Sigier from Morocco, who's been in very, very good form this year. Van Gatuni, normally seen over the steeplechase. We've seen him running some fast races over the barriers. He's probably looking for a fast one here on the flat. So Baumann, if he is going to commit himself, which it looks as though he is going to, he's going to have his work cut out. No doubt he'll get it all his own way. It's going to be interesting to see what his tactics may be. Frank O'Mara, who himself is trying to get him into some sort of shape and said he's going to be pacemaking for 2-3 weeks. Certainly did a job in Nice, and he's again doing the same thing here in Oslo. It's not all that easy, Tim, as you'll know, to go out and run 60-second laps at the front. You've got to be in pretty good shape yourself just to do that.
Well, that's right. I mean, Frank O'Mara, world-class man in his own right. He's a 13-13 man over 5,000. He is getting on in years now, no doubt about that. Perhaps just trying to race himself or pacemake himself into shape here for Gothenburg. But working hard there, 2:31 at 1,000, so still operating at around 60-second pace, and that would bring them home in around 7:35. Baumann looking very, very comfortable there in second place for my money. Bitok in third place, always very impressive-looking athlete for my money. Hissou there, back and forth with Ismail Karoui leaning on him a little bit in the red shorts. Kidui, who looked excellent in Lausanne, winning at 5,000 in 13.07. Lovely to see the little Kenyan back into his best form. He moves through now into fourth place. But still Frank O'Mara pulling them around. They went through three laps there in around 3:02, 3:02.5. And what's impressive, Steve, really, in contrast with that women's 3,000 that we talked about earlier, is look at that, a group of about 15 men going round quite happily after 3.5 laps at 60 second pace.
Well, that's been a feature really of distance running so far this year, is that even in the big fast races, even the world record race in Rome, which Kip Tanui in the end won, you never really knew who was going to come out of the pack and win and get the fastest time. They all were running very, very quick indeed, and there's often been three, four, five people going into the last lap, the last 600 metres or so, even when it's been at world record pace. And I think that's been a real feature of distance running so far this year. As you said, possibly not in 3,000, but tonight could be an opportunity really for some of the guys to run a lot faster than they have so far this year, because this is good pace making from Frank O'Mara. He's done his job well there, gone through four laps. And Dieter Baumann, well, he's going to be left out in front here now. This is interesting to see. Looks very, very relaxed, I have to say that. But he's got a phalanx of Africans sitting on his shoulder, Kenyans, Moroccans, and really, well, he's obviously made the decision. I don't like being in the front. Thank you, guys. One of you can take it on from here.
Well, it looks to me like he'd asked for 60-second pace up to four laps. O'Mara did almost that, about 4.02 there at four laps. But Baumann, I'm sure, didn't expect quite so many people to be right up behind him. DiNapoli is still there. Sean Crichton, the Australian, has moved through into second place. He's been in great shape recently, 13.17 just a couple of weeks ago. Better known as a steeplechaser, but look at that. Chasing down 120 here and looking very happy with it. That's Philip Mossimer out in front at this stage. As you said, I think Baumann has decided to make it a race rather than a time trial, Steve. Now he knows the full strength of this field. And at 5.06 at 2,000, he's decided just to unleash that kick of his, I think, in the latter stages if he can stay with it. But he is looking comfortable. This is so impressive. Not often do you see a pack this large moving around at this sort of pace. It can be anybody's race yet.
Certainly, and I think the interesting thing is going to be, has Baumann really got the kick to deal with this? I remember talking about a race early on this season, assuming, at a much slower pace than this, assuming that Baumann would be able to kick his way through to victory, and he obviously wasn't in the shape back then. And the likes of Salah Hissu, who's shown some good pace over the last lap and the two previous races so far this year, may have enough to hold off Baumann. You never know. It's always difficult as athletes get older to maintain that startling kick. And there you see Hissu, who's now taking it on. He's been in very, very good form, and he's not going to hang around to wait this evening. It's been a good pace so far. He doesn't want to see that pace drop, and this is good to see. Somebody who's prepared to keep the pace going, take it on. And Baumann, very quick to react, moves himself out, and this really is a jump back to form for Dieter Baumann, if you like. He still looks very, very, very relaxed to me, as does Hissu indeed in front.
Little skier there in third place for Morocco. Really has been racing superbly recently, ran well in Nice last week. And he's stepped up a grade in ability this year, and he's covering everything from Baumann and Hissu at this stage.
Well, this is incredible to see, really. Baumann isn't going to hang around. Maybe he's not quite sure about his pace over the last 200 as they hit the bell there and what looks like a very, very fast time. Baumann has gone for it early. He's hit the front with 400 to go. He's opening up a 5-6 meter gap. He's not really pulling away anymore. He's took the others by surprise. And really, this is unusual to see for Dieter Baumann. We would have expected him to wait for the last 200. He's struck for home early. Obviously felt as though he had it in his legs. And at the moment, it looks as though he's done the right thing. Coming round now with just about 150 to go. The crowd are cheering him on. It's been a great race. Behind him, Siguier is in second place with Bitok closing on him very, very quickly. But Baumann coming into the home straight. Looks as though he's done enough. Very, very fast finishing. Paul Bitok coming through into second place, but it's Baumann who strides away, looking over his shoulder. He's got the race won, coming through to win in a very, very fast time. 7.33.57, in fact, knocks a couple of tenths off his personal best. And of course, that would signify a German record. Sven Arne Hansen, the meet promoter, first to congratulate him. And that is one happy man indeed. That is a big, big leap forward in terms of his form, Tim. And Dieter Baumann is back.
Certainly is. Baumann there setting a personal best, which was 4 years old. As you said, just a few hundreds faster than his personal best. But I think the significance of that run is that he's beaten a lot of the best men in the world. Hissu has been a danger man all season in fast or slow races. Zgir himself, the little Moroccan, has been knocking himself into incredible shape over the last two or three weeks. And for Baumann, that is a massive improvement on any previous race we've seen from him this year. He treated the German Championships weekend 2 weeks ago as a training weekend, in effect. Won both the 1500 and 5000 there. But Steve, as you said, Haven't seen a great deal of him over the last month internationally. Now we know what's been going on. He's been training very hard and doing plenty of speed work. And for my money, Bowman looks as capable of lifting the world title as anybody else off that sort of form. His speed over the last 300 or 400 metres is as good as anybody's.
So there you see the result.